You off, you've learned.
That gave me a renewed sense of purpose.
Oh, that's.
Even take her free.
Grass is the largest.
Because we love him for ourselves.
And Adam Wright with.
First star. Need your help.
Release from Mac.
Got a 1966 Ford Galaxie AM radio. This radio was super clean. It did polish up good. We polished all the chrome on it. We've done a full Aurora Design conversion. I'm going to demonstrate it like I normally do for the owner and everybody else to see if they want to. It has a AM and FM stereo, auxiliary in, which is automatic, USB port. This is your harness you'll be getting. Charge your phone, your devices, play a thumb drive, which comes with it, with the video and music on it. Auxiliary in here, which is automatic. I'll be demonstrating that for you. Push button operated. Has Bluetooth. Hand-free phone calls, screaming your music, everything. The radio will also scan your stations. And I'll be demonstrating all of it. And has voice ID, which is real neat in AM radio. This one's in great shape. It's not, sometimes these things here kind of look pretty bad. This one turned out nice. Now right now you're on FM. Underneath right there you got an operating LED, and over here you got a stereo LED. He wanted the blue, that's what we got. And you're on FM. And that's the color that you get for FM. You want to go to AM radio, you just simply turn it off and right back on. AM radio. And that's about 650. That should be it. The XM.
AM 650. Yep.
All right, we'll turn it back off and right back on. There's FM. Now, you don't have an FM dial, so the voice ID comes in handy.
FM 89.5.
So anytime you're on FM, you want to know where you're at.
FM 96.3,
which is pretty cool. We got all the presets lubed up, everything works good on that, so you can preset it. You have a built-in mic right here, which the lens and all the way this radio goes in, it'd be just barely where you can see it. And you have an extra mic that you can actually plug in and get it closer to you. I don't know how loud the car is, could be loud. Treble and bass like you've always had. And depending on how many speakers you hook up, if you hook up two speakers, you'll have balance built in your toner control. If you hook up three or more, you'll have balance and fader. And there's two ways to get to it. I'll demonstrate that for you. Let's go into fader. It's easier if you just back us up just a little bit, about midways. A quick punch and hold down. One, two.
Fader adjust.
There's your rears. There's your fronts. So as long as you're moving, it'll stay in that mode till you find what you want. You're going to set your speakers up where you like them. I like these right there. We're going to stop moving it. Let her set it.
Fader set.
All right. Now we're going to go into balance. Of course, we've got to have music so we know what we're going on. Two quick pushes and a hold. One, two, hold.
Balance adjust.
There's the right side. The left side.
Those shifts, and look, Kelly, you work evenings. I've done it before as well. It's not an easy schedule.
Mm-hmm.
And it's often
balance
the moments
it out,
I play FM when I would
move
my
it.
Car after
she'll
a
set
night
it.
Shift. And
balance set.
Now you're back on treble and bass.
Just to exit.
That way you can set up your speakers. Now it does have pre-outs on it if you want to add an amp to your rear speakers and put a sub in. And I like adding subs. They definitely make the radio come alive and let your normal speakers do what they're supposed to do without you trying to get all the bass out of the 6 by 9s or these here 5 by 7s.
There's some people who have been on the phone and we're getting those calculations going, but there's still room for
now, there's other ways to get to it. You can still get your balance and fader here. You read your instruction because it's all in your instructions. Voice ID, you can get to it here. 1, 2, 3.
I'd love for you.
FM 89.
Same thing you do here.
T-shirt, but to know
now we can put this radio in scan going down the road and let it find you a station. You can hit this 4 quick times or turn this twice.
Scanning for stations.
That he thinks
now it's
going
to go from station to station.
Was,
I'll show you how to lock on station, find it on the dial in case you want to preset it and identify it. We're going to let it go a couple stations.
And I'm just going to remind parents, when you're in the car, you have a captive audience. And so when you're driving, I remember when our kids turned.
See, like that station there, all you do is turn it once.
Station hold.
She'll lock on it. As soon as she says that, you can start moving it till you find it. There it is. Pull out a preset and save it. That's what that light flashing on me. Good strong sounding radio. I like it. Sounds great. Alright, auxiliary in. Just pull out your male to male cord that comes with it. Plug it in. And plug in your device. We're going to put a little MP3 on it. You put satellite radio, CD changers, XM radio, anything that's got a head that puts out a signal. Plug it in, turn it on, and automatically changes to it. All you do is turn it on. That's your auxiliary in. You notice the little lights go on the green. That means auxiliary in. So anytime you're on auxiliary in, you want to go back to radio, just take that device and turn it off. And in 20 seconds, if you don't touch the radio, it'll automatically change back by itself. But if you want to shorten that 20 seconds, just turn the radio off and right back on. It remembers where you're at. During that 20 seconds, it won't go to AM. It'll stay where you had it. That's how your auxiliary in devices work. And now we're going to pair the Bluetooth up, and you'll do the initial pair up on your phone. It will take multiple devices. It'll always pick number one. So we're going to do a little test on it. We're going to go to here. Let's see if my phone will pick it up, because I got a lot in here I've been doing. Now you can turn this up twice or hold this button down to pair up. Let's do it here.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Showed up on her phone. All we got to do is tap on it. She'll tell us when it's done.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Now we're connected up. We're going to do a voice command. But you can bring your phone up and go to music and hit play, and it'll automatically change over. Put your phone down. It's designed so you don't have this in your hands while you're driving. You don't need it in your hands. It'll let you know when you get a text. It'll let you know Amber Alerts. Anything your smartphone is always used to doing, it'll come through the speakers on your system. Let's do a voice command. We're going to check this little mic out because I hadn't checked it out yet. You can turn this up twice again and bring your phone up, or you can hold this button down. See, we're lit up now. Let's hold it down. Play music. Well, we know that's working. There we go. Alright, I'm going to show you how to do this. Now, you don't even have to look at your phone. I'm doing it to show you what it will do. You can advance your music here one time. That'll advance. Twice to back up or repeat. Depends on how long you're in the song. You can turn your needle up. You can even do it with a push button as long as that tuner is moving. Back up, repeat. See, I was into it a little long. That's how you scream your music. Now, a phone call comes in. She'll come on and say, incoming call. All you do is press this button once, turn your tuner up once to answer your call. You want to end the call twice here, down, it'll end the call, or just let the phone hang up. It'll go back doing whatever you had it doing. Now we're going to do a voice command, and we're going to use this. And let's go back to radio. Stop music. See, I went a little quick so I didn't hear that. Stop music. My phone sometimes just don't understand redneck. Now we're back on radio. And what we're going to do now is we're going to turn it off. You shouldn't have to pair your phone up but one time. And of course, now if you get a new phone, you got to pair it up. Or if you have trouble with your phone, I do with mine. Smartphones, they named them exactly what they are, smartphones. I like the lady on mine drinks a lot, but that's me. She seems to be pretty sober tonight. And what we're going to do is when we turn it on, you get in the car, you done the pair up, it'll find your radio.
Bluetooth connected.
That way you're connected up. All right, that's how your Bluetooth, screaming your music, phone calls, all that work. Now we're going to do a thumb drive. You'll get one of these with this video on it, some music, and you can take that redneck stuff off where I put on there and put whatever you like on it. But the file's already built for you. So let's go to it. You can hide this or put it in a cigarette lighter, whichever way you want to do. You can mount this thing anywhere. Cigarette lighter. I've been known to put them in a cigarette lighter, so the cigarette lighter actually works the button or underneath the lip of the dash. And plug this in, go straight to it. And it operates the same as your phone. If you want to change the songs, turn it up. Up, back. Up. Repeat. Back. Now we went up here, up twice to summon our phone up. We can go down and put this in pause. We don't have to take this out unless you want to charge your phone. Or we can hold this 1 second. Pause, right back to radio. This light's going to flash a couple times along with that one. And let's go back to radio. Let's cycle back around. There we go, cycle back. Let's go back to thumb drive and we'll do it for you on this one and that one. Back to thumb drive. Down. Twice, put it in pause, right back to radio. I'm checking the radio out, that's why I do this. And for the owner to see it, read your instructions, it'll do a whole lot more than what it's doing. Down, right back to thumb drive. Let's go back to radio. Wiring harness. I wanted to get into that one of these days, might as well do it now. You get your wiring harness, it plugs in right here. Yours will have the original plugs on it to plug back into your original harness. If you don't have that, just cut them off and hot wire it in. You have a light, the orange one goes to your dash light, so when your dash lights come on, this light comes on. That way it'll dim with it and everything, that way the dash stays the same. Hot wire can go to fuse box or key. Now if you plug in the original plug, you're going to the fuse box. Make sure you up that fuse to at least a 10 amp in the fuse box or you'll blow it and you'll be calling the radio man. My radio quit. You've got a 10 amp fuse in the wiring harness, so make it a 10 amp in your fuse box, or you can go to the key so when you turn the key on, the radio has juice. You got a ground, even though, well, I just unplugged it. Even though the radio is grounded inside here, and when you wire it up, it'll be grounded. You got an extra ground that helps you out.
RVs and a limited number of rustic yurts.
Bluetooth connected.
There we go. Nearby kayak rental and a jam. Speaker wires. You got 8 wires there, color coded. Each speaker gets its own hot and ground. Don't combine grounds. If you put new speakers in, mark your wires and wire it up where each speaker has its own hot and ground. That way you have balanced fader, quiet system. The blue wire will be sealed off like this one is. It is to tell an antenna to come up or a remote wire for your amplifiers. or anything else you want to use it. It becomes 12 volt hot when you turn this radio on. And it has no choice in that. That's what it's going to be. So I seal these off because a lot of people don't use them. And there'll be 12 volts hanging on the dash that you don't need arcing out. But that's what the blue wire is for. It does not require batteries. It does not require 12 volt consistent to maintain a memory. So if you change your battery or disconnect it, store the car, when you put it back on there, it goes right back to doing what you had it doing. That's one thing I like about the Aurora design. And the sound. Now when someone tells the story, this old road is new again. This old road is new again. Oh, the times they were a-changin', and there is a time. Play music. Back on Bluetooth. Stop music. Pause. Right back to radio.
All to double your money. You can give an
66 Ford Galaxie AM radio with a full Aurora design. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. And that's all I got to say about this one. It's late. I'm fixing to go put the video in the computer and get ready for bed. Thank you.